So, quick and easy. Here's a full explanation of the latest Minecraft snapshot. It's the first experimental snapshot for the 1.19 wild update that contains all about the deep dark biome and the warden and ancient cities and so on. And in this video we will keep it short and simple, but hopefully fully covered. Let's start with the deep dark biome. You can find it deep underground in the deep slate area, and in creative mode you can also find it with the locate biome command. So it's basically a new cave biome. The floor of the deep dark biome is covered in skulk, and the only mob that can spawn in here is the warden. Of course it's much darker than you can see here. I raised the gamma value so that you can see more throughout the whole video. In this deep dark biome you can find ancient cities. These are structures like temples, villages and so on that can generate in this biome here. And don't misunderstand a few things, this is a normal mineshaft that also generated in the same spot where the ancient city generated. So normally it would look a little bit more like this maybe, without all the wood. Also, this ancient city in this deep dark biome is a little bit under a dripstone cave, so it's only partially a deep dark biome, also partially a dripstone cave biome, so you can see other mobs spawning in here, which should normally not be possible. The ancient city has a center structure like this with a frame of reinforced deep slate. You can't mine these blocks, well, you can break them, but they won't drop. They are extremely hard, take extremely long to break, longer than obsidian, and have no current use. They are only available in the creative mode menu. You will be able to find some neat loot in these dungeon chests. For example, a new enchantment. It's called Swift Sneak, and we will showcase it in a moment. Next, here are the new skulk blocks. So this is a skulk sensor. I think many of you already know what this block is doing. It can sense vibrations and relay them to other skulk sensors and trigger the skulk shriekers to call the warden. And this block has been in the game already in the Minecraft 1.17 version, only in game mode obviously, but I think many of you already know the details about this block, so we will keep it short and skip it. Next, there are skulk catalysts. They will spawn or generate randomly here in the deep dark, and they are something special. If a mob dies near them, we can simulate this with a pick, then this skulk catalyst will spread skulk blocks and skulk veins around, and I think it will check if a mob dies within an 8-block radius, and you should see some bubbles forming, a bubble effect, where the skulk is spreading. The right tool for mining or breaking skulk blocks is the hoe, and if you mine one of these normal skulk blocks, you can get some XP out of it. So they are basically XP storage blocks, and they will suck out the XP that is dropping from the mob and put it into the ground and converting blocks around to these new skulk blocks. So maybe this is good for XP farms, we will see. Now let's take a look at the skulk shrieker. When a skulk sensor relays some vibrations to the skulk shrieker, it will call a warden. Not every time, but sometimes if a warden is near, then it will emerge from the ground. But considering the warden, we will come to it in a minute. Next, there's a new effect that you can only see in survival mode, not in game mode. So it should have happened a few seconds ago, but if you do this in survival mode, you will get it when the skulk shrieker activates. You will see a darkness effect coming not only from the skulk shrieker, but also from the warden. It can give the effect to the player as well, and everything is flashing dark and coming back, and light sources are a bit lighter. You can control how dark the darkness effect gets when a warden or skulk shrieker gives it to you, but it will not affect the fog distance. So you can raise it from 50% to 100%, 100% is default, or you can also turn it completely off, it depends on whatever you want. And yeah, it will come in periodic pulses and will be totally weird. It will still be darker than you see here, because, as I already told you, the gamma value is way higher than normal, and it would be way darker without this gamma value at 10. Next thing on the list is the new enchantment. I already applied it to some netherite boots, and swift sneak is only to be found here in these dungeon chests. You cannot find them anywhere else. And let's see what this enchantment is doing. You cannot combine it with Depth Strider and Soul Speed, and also not with Frostwalker. So it's, you maybe need another equipment set. So let's sneak with it. It's almost like walking normally. Somehow you are a bit faster if you walk in two directions at the same time, diagonally. And if you walk straight forward, it will still be way faster than normal sneaking. And this is normal walking. And sneaking two directions is basically as fast as normal walking. Maybe a bit faster. Somehow not that precise to be determined. There is further investigation needed. But sneaking is really OP now. And now let's finally get to the warden. Let's summon one. So the Skulk sensor is triggering the Skulk Shrieker, and the warden should be appearing in a second. So there it is. I'm going back to survival mode, and just for testing purposes, I do have a resistance effect, so it won't be able to damage me at all. But there's his, oh yes, it's making some noise, and now it should be charging at me. Yes. And it will basically beat the crap out of me. And normally it would kill me with one hit without armor. I could use full netherite armor and it would only take 4 or 5 hits and I'm basically dead. Full enchanted protection and so on. And you can hear this pumping heart, and the louder it's pumping, the faster it's pumping, the more aggressive and angry it is. So I made a lot of noise, and it's at full speed. Oh yes. If this warden does not receive signals from me, or vibrations from me, it will calm down after a while. And it starts sniffing around because it can't sense the player with vibrations. It tries to use its sense of smell, as you can see here and also here. And after 1 minute, when the player has not made any sound or any vibration, or its player is far enough away, the warden will bury itself underground again. And it's gone. So this is how it looks. The animations are very, very awesome so far, from my opinion. I think this is the most interesting and the most important stuff about the snapshot. If you want to see more, also more videos, it would be very awesome if you leave a like for the YouTube algorithm. Helps a lot. And stay subscribed for my videos, as there will be coming more.